everybody. I'm Cinnamon Cooney, your Art Sherpa, and today I have something completely shocking to tell you. I'm going to paint this lemon without any yellow paint. No, I really am going to paint this lemon without any yellow paint. So this is part of a series. Last week we painted red without red, and you guys asked me about it. And this week we're going to paint yellow without yellow. In fact, I'm going to do this whole painting with orange, green, and purple. As mind-blowing as that is, that's about to happen. So in this video, I'm going to show you the painting being created. I'm going to explain to you why it works. I am going to explain what materials and colors will do this. And I'm even going to, in this one, demo the color mix and how you can do that yourself at home, because it's really important that you test it. If you're at all not believing me, I do want you to get your paint out and test me. Test this trick yourself in your own studio at home. I know I'm going to be challenging you as that for this whole thing. I'm so excited to do this. All right, get your paint, get your brushes, come back. I'm going to show you how I painted this lemon. In a total act of transparency, I like to put my paint out and show you what brands exactly I'm using. So those paint brands that you saw are what's out on the palette. I have Cad Red Medium Hue. I've got Brilliant Green, Thalo Green, and Dox Purple. So as promised, these are secondary colors. I'm sketching out my lemon just so I know where I put my paint. It is a yellow watercolor pencil, which in no way helped the painting be lemony. And anything. I just wanted something that wasn't going to be too staining to the paint. You might be noticing that I'm mixing blue with Dox Purple and Thalo Green. If you painted with me for a minute, this is a mix you're very familiar with. We use it for like cloudy days and shadows and things a lot, but we've never really pulled it out and like pointed to it, gone, this is blue. Have you noticed? We just kind of have used it. So it's kind of exciting to use it here. Don't spoil it for people when we come back and do a blueberry later. Just be surprised with us. There I am taking the Cad Orange and the Brilliant Green and white, and it is yellow. And just to be candid, just to be transparent, when I did this, I was surprised at how yellow it was. I was like expecting to sit there and say the stuff I'm seeing on TikTok or the stuff I'm seeing on YouTube is probably color adjusted to look like this. And it really hasn't been. You know, we answered that first question about red without red. Again, I'm going to shout out Cesar Cordova, who I think kicked that off, and definitely link in the description below if you want to know more about this and see some more artists doing that. Here I am adding the inside of the wedge. If you're wondering, how did I get the lighter yellows and how did I get the deeper yellows? I would add a lot more white to my yellow mixture. And then come back and add a little more orange when I wanted to deepen it. And then we'll go back to the red mix later on in the video. I mean, this is crazy, isn't it? Because they tell you since grade school, don't they? They tell you things, many things in kindergarten, some of which maybe is not as accurate as it could be. But one of them is that you can't mix primary colors. And so I think we translate that into our minds is that I can't make yellow and I can't make red and I can't make blue. And we can. Are these primary yellows, primary reds, and primary blues? This is a question of light and pigment, which really has two separate answers. And if you realize the purple doesn't exist for you anyways, you're just hallucinating that. And really everything that you're seeing is kind of your brain's subjective response to light being reflected off pigment. There's a lot to cover here. But in this, I think we can all come together and go, wow, that's a really yellow lemon. And I think I kept thinking this through the whole thing. Now, I do want to add a little shadow. I'm an art teacher. I teach a full long paintings online. And number one thing you can do to improve your paintings, just as a weird unrelated tip, is please add shadows. Because solid objects break light. Now, to add the shadows on here, I did get into a little more green. And that's how I kind of got that shadow color going. I did a lot of blending. I didn't use any mediums or any extra anything. What is happening on the palette is what is happening. There isn't anything off palette. There isn't any camera trickery. This isn't color adjusted to look yellow. And you guys kept asking me in the last red video, do you mind if I test it? Or even more like challenging, like I'm going to test this because this doesn't feel true. Please test this. Test this in your watercolor. Test this in your gouache. Test this in your oils. Test these color challenges. Let me know. Do you want me to see me do the blue? I've got some really great color mixing tricks that you know, but you don't know you know. And sometimes mentally we forget the tools that we have in our paint box that are available to us. Another thing I want to say is it's important to practice things like this. Like this lemon, in the middle of this, I realized, wow, this is a really nice value study to just to be doing, like as a warm up. The painting itself only took me 45 minutes in real time. It wasn't a very long painting. It came together really easily. And I enjoyed the process of it. I did not expect to enjoy this series as much as I have. I've enjoyed making the paintings. John's really enjoyed making the videos. Here we are getting back into that blue, which is crazy. Now, this is where you normally see us use the blue if you paint with me, is in shadows. This is my alternate blue to using ultramarine. I think it's even in my 403 color mixes video. So we've covered a few color mixes before, but this was a little more digestible and watchable, right? Can you see how we tune in the yellow by really finding that balance between the brilliant green and the cat orange and white? And that's how we find the depth and range in the yellow. Now here I'm going to pull the Doc's purple and the cat orange hue together. And if you'll remember, you're like, wait, didn't we just do a strawberry with that? Yeah, we did. We did. That's how versatile this process is. You can paint a shocking variety with huge range of paintings that are not dull, that are not limited, that are not grayed out with good secondary colors. Definitely on this one, I tested it across a bunch of brands. I'll show you at the end. I tested across brands and found that you could get good results with Hughes student paints and professional paints. They were both kind of one-to-one and equal. Don't forget to add those little moments of brightness there. I definitely played with my two greens, my phthalo green and my brilliant green in this. And I really enjoyed that, getting in there and tuning it in. That last little bit where you tune in a painting, that's where the fun sort of is, I think, in acrylic painting. And come in here and sign it with my little signature brush. And then let's talk about what paints work and how they work. So here is the painting that you saw in the video that just came through. And you can see it's quite yellow. And here is the exact paint that I put out, plus others that I tested. If you were to wear the level 3 Artist Loft, is actually professional paint. They do make a student paint, but this is the professional paint. I have abstract in a couple bodies here. It is the bright yellow green, or sometimes it will be called brilliant yellow green, that we're talking about. I felt like you could probably get away with phthalo green yellow shade, but really you're going to want to look for something that says brilliant yellow green. And then the cad orange hue. Now I have cadmium orange here. I have cadmium orange hue, and this is listed as orange, red, orange. So those are the colors, but this is the range that you're looking for. I had wished last time on the red one that I had just showed you the mix. So I'm going to show you the mix too on this video, because I really want you guys to test this at home. So my whole thing in art is not just that I show art, I teach art. So I do want you guys to see this mix happen, especially for new painting. I'm going to take a brush and get it slightly damp and pull out my orange. You can kind of see the range of that, and get my green over here. And we're going to mix these together. I'm going to keep adding green. And there's this point where you can really sort of tip it and see it go yellow, and you see it on the palette. But where it will really come together for you is where you add the white to it. That's what reveals the yellow. So if you pull this out here, you can see that that's quite yellow as you go. I can brighten that yellow, I found, by adding a little bit of green in there. And you can get that a little bit in the brighter ranges. And then we could deepen the yellow more towards like maybe even an ochre by adding a little bit of orange. So it really was a whole range of yellows. But the trick is just trying to find, here's a great one here, where you add a lot more white to it. So you get a full range of colors, and you've just got to balance between those two. It's not that hard to find it. It's pretty easy to get it away from the browns. I found that wasn't difficult at all. Now you can see me doing that. So that's how I got that color, and that way you could see the mix happening in real time. So hopefully that gave you some more ideas about that there really aren't, I mean, you know, there's no limitations to painting, but sometimes we have beliefs, right? Or core ideas about things that we can do and can't do that we carry with us. One of them being that you can't mix yellow, or you can't mix red, or you can't mix blue. And I love that we're reexamining that belief, because Clearly you can. And any time that you can look back at something you hold as true in art, except for the don't eat paint and don't set fire to paint, which we know is absolutely sacred. But outside of that, things that you believe are true or conditional in your painting might actually be more flexible than you're thinking, allows you to be flexible and more creative in yourself. Let me know if you're ready to see blue without blue or other magic color mixes in the comments below. In fact, tell me what color would you like to learn how to mix and what's the hardest color for you to mix down here. And this isn't just to get comments. I actually will answer these questions with videos that teach you how to solve those problems. Be good to yourself. Be good to each other. And I want to see you at an easel really soon. Bye-bye.